In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a pin on Pinterest for your print-on-demand shops. This can work for Redbubble or any other print-on-demand shop. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. And in this video, I wanted to teach you more about Pinterest. So I made a video recently, this one right here, about how to promote your stuff with social media from Redbubble. And one of the things that I didn't show because of time is how to do Pinterest. I kind of assumed that it worked just like the other ones, but what's happening is Pinterest cannot fetch the image on Redbubble. So you're seeing these errors, and I got a lot of these comments that it didn't work. So I'm gonna show you a workaround on Pinterest, how to do it. And this can work for Redbubble as well as any other pod site. So this is gonna work well if you wanna promote Amazon, or you want to promote TeePublic or whatever print-on-demand site that you're doing, Etsy even, you can do it this way. I'm also going to show you a way to make your pins stand out. So a lot of people do the easy route and all the pins kind of look the same. I'm going to show you how to make it stand out and make it look a little different than things that are already out there so that you get more eyeballs on your pins. So stay tuned for that. I'm going to put that at the end. Let's get into Pinterest right now and I'll show you what I mean. So here we are on Pinterest. Your page may look different, but I'm just on my business hub if you have a business account. But you should have these right here, these tabs. We're gonna hit create and go create a pin. And you can see this is your basic pin right here. We're gonna need a few things. We're gonna need a photo. We're gonna need a title and a description, which you should have no matter what print-on-demand shop you're doing. And then a destination link. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. So let's do it for Redbubble first. I'm gonna go here to Redbubble. This is my store. Pick any one on your store. You don't wanna promote mine. If you wanna promote mine, that's great. But let's pick one. Let's say it's this one right here. I'll pick your own t-shirt. You can pick a sticker as well if you want. So when you go scroll down here, you're gonna see a lot of other pictures here. So you can pick whichever one you want on here on Redbubble. So let's say I wanna pick this one right here, or this one right here. I'm gonna right click on it, and it's gonna give me some options, and I'm gonna do open image in new tab. Now this may be different for a PC. I'm on a Mac right now, so hopefully it works for you guys on a PC, but you can see this is right here, and I'm gonna save this to my desktop. So I'm just gonna drag it to my desktop right here. You can't see it, it's off screen, but it's on my desktop. Now I'm gonna go back to Pinterest and I'm gonna drag that into here. Now, Pinterest is saying that they recommend at least 1,000 pixels by 1,500 pixels. You can ignore that, but if you wanna do that the right size, I'm gonna show you how to do that just in a little bit. But let's do these parts first. Add your title. All of this should be on here. So you can grab the title here, do that, and do Command C. You know, copy, whatever your copy shortcut is on PC, and then come here back to Pinterest and do that. And you should also have something that you wrote about your shirt here underneath. So use that as your description, whatever you wrote. Hopefully you wrote something. If not, you can just type something in here and just copy paste that in here. And then the destination link will be this URL at the top. So double click, copy, go back to Pinterest, boom, very easy. Now, one thing we could do is change this size to make it 1000 pixels by 1500 pixels. I'll show you how to do that. You can do that in Affinity Designer, in Canva, or Photopea. Photopea is free for everyone, so I'm gonna show you how to do that. So is Canva, but let me show you how to do it in Photopea. New project, and I'm just gonna type in 1000 by 1500, right? And then this can be whatever, it can be 72 pixels per inch. You can make it higher if you want. And then we're just gonna hit create. And now we're gonna drag our photo into here and we're gonna size it up. Now this isn't the best way because this is pixels and we're sizing it up. So it's gonna be a little bit grainy, but not too bad because it's pretty close in size. We're sizing it up from 1000 to 1500. Right, so if you do it right to the edge, you can do that. And now when you save this one, hit background and go save. save as PSD or export as JPEG, you can do that. And we're gonna just call it t-shirt. Boom, and you can see it's the width is 1000, height 1500, just like what Pinterest really wants. So we're gonna save that. It's gonna save to my desktop. I'm gonna go back to Pinterest. I'm gonna grab that and let's get rid of this one, delete image, and drag in the new one. And hopefully it doesn't give us that warning about the size. You can see it's the right size now. Pinterest wants these tall rectangle shapes, right? And now we're just gonna pick the right one. If you have more than one board, you're gonna wanna pick one. I have one that's called Redbubble T-shirts, Detour Shirts on Redbubble. I'm gonna hit that right there and then hit publish. And then that's all there is to it to make a pin. Now you can use these same steps for whatever print on demand site you're using, Etsy, Shopify, right? And then we can see our pin right here. And this is what it's gonna look like. Now you can see a lot of people are using the same thing, right? So you're not gonna really stand out that much. So I'm gonna show you how you can stand out just a little bit more by using some other apps online. So one way to stand out and make your pin stand out is to use other apps to help you design graphic design apps. And one way to do that is Placeit. So if you haven't used Placeit before, this is placeit.net. It's great for mockups and other things. It also does little videos, which Pinterest can use as well. So you can stand out with video while everybody else is flat and not moving, your pins could be moving. So let me show you how to do some of these things. Of course, they have mockups, so we can just do mockups, and let's go to print on demand and just do t-shirts, for example. And you can see you can put all your designs, any of your designs on t-shirts on any of these models and save that as the right size. Size it in Photopea like we did and make sure that it's a pin. I'm gonna show you also, you can do this. Type in Pinterest on here and you can see Pinterest pins, Pinterest template fashion. Let's see what that is. So you can see you can use any of these pins as a starting point for your stuff. You can also do videos. So let me show you videos here, social media, Instagram stories, Instagram posts, Facebook covers. Let's just do videos like that. So you could put your stuff in here. Let me show you one that I did recently, just putting a t-shirt design in a video. So I'm gonna go back to my downloads. You can see all my downloads here. If you've already done one, if you didn't know, that's where you find your downloads. And I did this one recently, so I'm gonna hit make more. So you can see this is a video right here, and you can upload a different design. You're just gonna make sure that it's the right size, upload it, and change the color of the t-shirt. You can see I can make the t-shirt a different color if I want to, but it's a video, so it's gonna render really slow and load the preview. But let me show you what it looks like on Pinterest. There you can see I can change the color. I can do different videos as well, so lots to do on Placeit to make yours stand out on Pinterest. Let me show you on Pinterest what this looks like. There, you can see now this is what it looks like on Pinterest. You have a moving thing, so this will help you have you stand out. You can watch it again. It's just a very short clip, but they'll see yours moving and that will catch their eye, right? So that's one way for you to stand out on Pinterest is to use something like Placeit to make sure that yours looks different than everybody else's. Use a different video, use a different design, have a way to make your thing stand out. And if you want me to show you step-by-step on how to use Placeit step-by-step, leave that in the comments. I know I went pretty quick there, but it's really self-explanatory on there. But if you need some help on how to do the videos and how to do the mock-ups, let me know in the comments and I can do a video for that. Another way to make your pin stand out is to use apps Canva or Affinity Designer or Photopea to create your own kind of design that nobody else has, not even a template. You're gonna do your own stuff. So let me show you how to do that. First, we're gonna need some photos. I'm gonna do one just with my stickers here. So you can see I have a bunch of stickers that are selling on my shop, and you can do the right click thing. So do right click and then open image in new tab. So I'm gonna pick six of these right here. I'll do this one, this one, this one. Let's see, that was 1, 2, 3, 4. I think this is this one and this one. All right, so you can see I have all the tabs up here, and we're gonna go into Photopea right here. Remember this one where we had this? We're gonna close that, but we're gonna drag some of these other ones in here. We're gonna drag this to the desktops first. So let's drag all six. One, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Good. And that was the other one. Okay, so on Photopea, remember it is 1,000 by 1,500, right? So if we bring these in and scale them down to 500, so you can see right there the width and the height. So just do 500. Now we can fill this. Now you can do it any way you want, but this is an easy way to do something different. Bring it here, and we're just gonna stack these 500. So the reason why I'm doing this is because most pins only have one design, and the way to stand out on this pin is to make multiple designs on here, and you can put it any way you want. This is just a real simple way to do it. 500, 500, and because these are squares, they work perfectly, right? 500 there. And you can see how simple it is in Photopea just to do 500 right there and make sure that it kind of locks. You can kind of feel it locked there. And if you want to grab another one, this one is the wheel. You can just lock it there. And then this one there. And then the last one. And this could be your pin right here. And if you want to put something else, let's go back to the shop. You could have a logo right here. You can do the same thing, right click, and then open image in new tab. We got that avatar now, drag that down here and put that in Photopea. So if you wanna put your branding in here, you can do that too. You could even put words if you want, make this bigger, not too big because it's gonna pixelate. There you go. And this could be your pin for Pinterest. You could also put, get some stickers, you know, something like that, kawaii stickers or whatever you have. You can put some text in here. I'm not going to show you how to do that, but you can use things like Canva again, and here you got text. Just make it a little different. Put a lot of different things on here. I'm going to save this again, right? I'm going to export as JPEG, and I'm going to call this stickers. Boom. Save it. It's going to save to my downloads. Let's go back to Pinterest right here, and I'm going to pull up the downloads, the stickers. You can see right there. I can add my title. I could do detour shirts on, detour shirt stickers or whatever you want, right? And instead of just one, we can put this right here, this URL, our shop URL. Could do command C here. I believe there's also this share link. So you can also do this, share. It will copy your link. So let's go back to Pinterest. And then you can paste it, Command V, that's the link. And then you can just tell everybody about your store. And you should have title on your store here. Let's see if we scroll down, if you did it right, if I did it right. Right here, you can use that. So this may not be the best one, depending what you want. Or you can type your own thing so you can see fun stickers on Redbubble at Detour Shirts. Or maybe give them a call to action, right? Check out all the fun stickers. Okay. All right. And then we hit publish. Make sure you put it on the right one. So let me make sure that it's on Redbubble. And I have one that says stickers right here. And I'm gonna publish that. Let's take a look at it and see if anybody's done the same kind of thing. So we're gonna see our pin. And you can see nobody's done exactly the same kind of thing. You see some people with some other stickers and they do it like this where there's a lot of stickers, but mine is just a little bit different. Mine's a little bigger and stuff. So you can do yours in any different way. Overlay it like this, do it on a table. Whatever, right? So make sure that yours stands out. And you can see other pins right here are trying to make it stand out, right? Like making it like more like an ad, right? So the ones that stand out and catch your eye, right? Bigger like this. So have fun with this. This is another way to stand out. I would use things like Canva and cut things out and just make your pins just a little bit better so that it will catch people's eye and get those views that you need from Pinterest. So that is it for this video. Hopefully this video is really helpful for you. I know I shared just Redbubble, but you can do the exact same thing for merch by Amazon or TeePublic or Etsy or your Shopify store. Just copy and paste those things or type in the titles and make sure to use the right URL to point it to it. But make sure your pins stand out. Don't just use you can do that, but if you want your pins to stand out a little bit better, do some of these extra work, and I think that will pay off a lot better than just doing it quickly. So you gotta think about what will make yours stand out, what will make people wanna click on your pin over other people, right? Because there's just a whole bunch of pins on there on Pinterest. You wanna make yours stand out from other people. So that's what I would do. Hopefully this video was really helpful for you. If it was, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button. I got so many more videos coming along the way to help you in your print on demand journey. The question of the day for this video is, have you used Pinterest before? Let me know how you like it and if you've had some success with it. I would love to hear about that. Thanks again for watching. And if you want to see more videos on print on demand things, click on these right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.